Okay, so let us move on to the calomel electrode. Calomel electrode, as I told you, calomel is nothing but mercurous chloride, Hg2Cl2. Hg2Cl2. So you know the reference electrodes are used always as anode. The anodic reaction is nothing but 2Hg liquid plus 2Cl minus gives rise to Hg2Cl2 plus 2 electron. So what is the species here? The species here is mercury. Liquid mercury has been connected with saturated calomel, aqueous calomel, that is mercurous chloride. In the same phase, saturated KCl is also present. Saturated KCl is also present. The equilibrium reaction responsible for the EEA value, anodic potential of this reference electrode, is due to this off reaction. Calomel undergo reduction to get converted into elemental mercury, that is liquid mercury. If you consider the oxidation process, this will be reversed. 2Hg liquid plus 2Cl minus gives rise to calomel plus 2 electrons. If you write the Nernst equation for this reduction process, the E value for this anodic cell will be, as a consequence of this off reaction, that can be written as E is equal to E naught of Hg2Hg couple, Hg2Cl2Hd couple, minus 0.05916 divided by 2, because 2 electrons have been added to mercury. The oxidation state of mercury here is plus 1, not plus 2. So there are 2 mercury, plus 1, plus 1 means 2 electrons are required in order to convert plus 1 mercury to 0 valent or non-valent mercury. So 2 electrons have been added into log of Cl minus concentration to the power 2 in this reduction reaction. Chloride is the only ion obtained, and its number is 2, stoichiometry is 2. The moles of chloride ion resulted is 2. So Cl minus ion concentration to the power 2, we have to write it here. Pure mercury is obtained, its activity will be unity. Hg2Cl2 is a saturated solution, therefore its activity will also become unity. Therefore, E value is relied on the chloride ion concentration. From the electrochemical series, if you get the value of E naught for Hg plus Hg couple, that is plus 0.2682 volts. You can simplify this equation into this way. If you know the concentration of KCl here, so you can substitute, you can obtain the value of E. You can see here this part of information. The E value for this anodic reference electrode will be plus 0.2444 volts at 25 degrees Celsius when you use saturated KCl. Even by using the saturated KCl, the value of E will be plus 0.2376 at 35 degrees Celsius. So the value of E anode, is decreased while using this particular electrode if you increase the temperature. Why? If you increase the temperature, the chloride ion concentration keep on increases. As the concentration of chloride is increased, because E value is related to chloride ion concentration, this value will become high. As this value become high, this minus this will become definitely low. Therefore, E value has been lower. This is the demerit of this electrode. While using saturated calomel electrode, as the temperature is increased, the E value, the anodic potential of the calomel electrode keep on decreases as the temperature is increased. Therefore, this electrode is suitable only up to 80 degrees Celsius for use, provided the E value at the particular temperatures are known. If the temperature exceeds 80 degrees Celsius, this electrode will become unsuitable for use. Okay. This is about the calomel electrode. How do we construct this? Its construction is very simple. You need two tubes. One will be the external tube. and other one will be the internal tube. External tube is filled with saturated KCl and few crystals of KCl. Saturated KCl and few crystals of KCl are present in external tube. There is a provision to fill the KCl solution through this hole. There is a provision you can see in your laboratory while using saturated calomel electrode. You will be able to fill the saturated KCl solution into that. So crystals of KCl will be settled at the bottom of the electrode in the external tube. To the internal tube, you will be filling mercury, mercurous chloride and saturated KCl. So this portion is containing mercury, mercurous chloride and KCl. The upper portion will be containing elemental mercury. So mercury is going to act like a metal here as an electrode, and that is going to be connected to potentiometer by means of a aluminium wire or a platinum wire that is connected to potentiometer. So there is a frit made by asbestos. This frit will be acting like a salt bridge while using this electrode. The interconnection between the solution into which you have immersed the saturated calomel electrode and the solution present inside the electrode will be given through this frit as a salt bridge. So KCl will be acting like a species for the salt bridge. So its construction is very simple. You will take mercury in the inner tube, saturate with mercurous chloride and KCl, right? Connect the aluminium wire to the mercury and connect to the potentiometer from the internal tube. Into the external tube, you fill the saturated KCl solution and few crystals of KCl. As and when required, we will be able to fill the KCl solution into the external tube so that we can maintain the saturation level for KCl. There is an asbestos wick, the porous frit of asbestos wick, in order to provide the salt bridge. So this is the schematic representation of the saturated calomel electrode, and this is the systematic representation. Mercury here is put into mercurous chloride and KCl. This portion is indicating the presence of mercurous chloride and KCl, and mercurous chloride and KCl are present in the same phase. That's it. Very simple to represent systematically. The equilibrium reaction is from the calomel. It will undergo reduction to get converted into elemental mercury, and the EA value, the electrochemical potential for this anodic cell, is due to this off reaction. And this electrode is prone to vary the potential to the temperature. It is the potential of saturated calomel electrode is sensitive to the temperature, therefore it is suitable for use up to 80 degrees Celsius, but not greater than 80 degrees Celsius. Another important reference electrode is silver chloride electrode. So very simple to explain this silver chloride electrode, and very simple to understand even. Here a silver wire will be used. This silver wire is coated by silver chloride paste. This is going to be the silver chloride paste. A silver wire is pasted by silver chloride. Silver chloride precipitate you can prepare and you can coat to the tip of the silver wire. And you can immerse this silver wire coated with silver chloride into an external tube or a bigger tube which is having 1 cm to 2 cm diameter, which is having KCl solution. Here KCl solution concentration may be saturated or may be fixed. I will tell you what are the concentrations of KCl we will employ. So there is a porous plug which will act as a salt bridge in the electrode. This porous plug will be giving the connection between the solution into which this electrode has been immersed and the KCl solution. So movement is initiated. Right. Then this silver wire is connected to the potentiometer. Very simple. You need silver wire, silver chloride and KCl. This is a schematic representation. Systematically, silver wire is pasted with silver chloride saturated solution, and in the same phase KCl is present. A salt bridge is also existing to give the connection to KCl or AgCl. This is the off cell, and this off cell is acting like a reference electrode. The E cell value or the EA value of this reference electrode is due to this off reaction. silver undergo oxidation to get converted into silver ion. And because KCl is present, KCl will produce K plus and Cl minus ion. Cl minus from this will react with silver ion obtained from the oxidation process to produce silver chloride. So silver chloride will acquire one electron, gives rise to Ag solid plus Cl minus ion. So this is the Cl minus ion becoming responsible. With its concentration, we can relate the Nernst equation. So Ea can be written as E naught of Ag plus Ag couple minus 0.05916 divided by 1, because only one electron is associated here, into log of Cl minus concentration. Only one mole of Cl minus is involved. Therefore, Cl minus concentration to the power 1 will be presented here. From the electrochemical series, the standard state reduction potential for silver ion will be plus 0.2323 volts. So you can substitute here. If chloride ion concentration is known, E value can be obtained. Therefore, if you maintain 25 degrees Celsius, and if you use saturated KCl here in place of here inside the tube, the value of E will be plus 0.197 volts. If you use saturated KCl and at temperature 25 degrees Celsius, the value of E will be plus 0.197 volts. On the other hand, if you lower the concentration of KCl to 3.5 molar, at 3.5 molar, the E value will be increased to plus 0.205 volts, because the chloride ion concentration here, this should be the concentration, chloride ion concentration will be lower, this value will be lower and E value will become higher. So at lower concentration of KCl, the E value will be increases. So we can conclude that for this particular electrode, this is also sensitive to the concentration of KCl. If you use the lower concentration of KCl, E value will become higher. And one more thing while using this silver electrode is that while using this particular electrode, it is more temperature sensitive. It is more temperature sensitive. If you increase the temperature, the chloride ion concentration will become more and the E value will become lower. If you lower the temperature, the KCl concentration will become low and chloride ion concentration will be low, E value will become high. This is the first parameter. Therefore, as a result of the increased temperature, as a result of the increased temperature, the E value will become lower. As a result of the decreased temperature, E value will become higher for this particular electrode. Similarly, while using a silver chloride electrode, you have to make sure that the analyte solution should not contain any species which is having the capability to get complexed with silver. Say, silver cyanide may be formed if cyanide is present. Silver thiocyanate may be formed if thiocyanate is present. Silver fluoride may be formed if fluoride is present. Silver bromide is formed if bromide is present. Silver iodide is formed if iodide is present, especially in the determination of chloride. Not only in the determination of chloride, but also in the determination of iron, in the determination of whatever the species, manganese, whatever, zinc. If any species having the capability to get complexed with silver, that will poison the electrode, that is called as electrode. Sorry, that is called as electrode poisoning. So this electrode poisoning can be avoided by making sure that the analyte is free from such interferences. The interferences are able to form complex with silver. So this is about silver chloride electrode.